Chokwe Antar Lumumba is the incumbent candidate for mayor. He took office in 2017 after defeating former Mayor Tony Yarbor in the primary election that year.
It will take all of us that I want to hear from you in order to transform Jackson into a better inheritance for our children.
Lumumba walked into the job expecting to face big problems, including crime. On his watch, the deadliest year in the city's history, 128 homicides in 2020.
That is why I lifted up the issue of us having too many illegal weapons in our city. And I get calls from residents who say, listen, somebody's walking around the neighborhood with a gun, or they have an assault rifle, strapped across their chest. The reality is that now we live under laws that protect that.
The mayor said he issued executive orders to limit the access of guns within city limits. To combat violent crime, he credits the city's new real-time crime center.
A good portion of them are in areas that the data suggests.
And new technology-equipped police cruisers and more frequent police recruit classes. Also on the mayor's plate, the catastrophic failure of the city's water system following February's ice storm. Many decades of city leaders not fully addressing the problem have led to what the mayor says is a $2 billion problem. His conservative estimate is that roughly $1 billion alone is needed to fix Jackson's wastewater system and the other billion to address our drinking water, storm drainage, and roads and bridges.
It's not a matter of if, it's a matter of when these systems will fail. And so as we talk about these challenges, the systems we have are the systems we have until we no longer have these systems and we replace them.
The mayor says he's pushing for infrastructure funding that measures up to the amount of revenue Jackson contributes to the state of Mississippi's coffers. He has also encouraged that on a federal level, ongoing dialogue with the EPA will bear solutions. We also talked to the mayor about economic development. Lumumba says chains like Bed Bath & Beyond are pulling out of Jackson as they reduce their national footprint as a result of the pandemic. COVID-19 also hit local businesses hard. But with an improved city bond rating, the mayor says he expects more growth, with a focus on the Highway 80 corridor, downtown, and County Line Road, including the expansion toward Tougaloo College.